have, let me try to introduce two important terms. One is path length. Okay, as the name suggests, path length, length of the path, or path traced by the object. Okay, so what is the length? Length is expressed as distance. Distance traversed by the object. Okay, so in a particular time or in a time interval will be treated as path length. Okay, path length, it is nothing but distance traversed by the body or by the object. Distance traversed by the object is called as path length. Okay, so using this setup, I can tell you the distance traveled in different cases. Okay, I'm going to consider say three cases. You can think of any number of cases, no worries. Okay, so body is moving from say O to P, then body moves from O to P, and then from P it will coming back to Q. Okay, next case, body is moving from O to R, okay, and back to P. Okay, so let us try to calculate what is the path length. Okay, path length in these three cases. Okay, path length O to P, body is moving from, or object is moving from O to P. Okay, so in this case, path length, okay, equal to O P, body is moving from O to P, correct? So that is the path O P. Okay, so that is equal to so you have to calculate the distance of the point P from O, that is the distance traveled by the object. Okay, O P, so that is nothing but 400 meter. Okay, 400 meter. So this has only magnitude. So path length or distance traveled is a scalar quantity. You are going to discuss about this idea in the next chapter, motion in a plane, you may be knowing. Okay, so physical quantities are broadly divided into two, scalars and vectors. Scalars are those physical quantities which have only magnitude with no specified direction, whereas vectors are those physical quantities which have both magnitude and direction, okay, with a specified direction. Okay, so this is one example for a scalar. Distance is a scalar. Okay, path length equal to 400 meter. Okay, now body is moving from O to P and back to Q. So here path length of the path, okay, O to P, body is moving from O to P, from O to P, OP, path is OP, and back to Q, from P to Q, that is PQ, that's all. Okay, OP, okay, OP is 400 meter plus PQ, PQ is, okay, 50, okay, 100, okay, 150, 200, 250, right? So 50, 50, 100, 100, 200, 250. 250 meters, so 400 plus 250, okay, 650 meter is the path length in this course of motion, or in this case, body is moving from O to P, and from P it will be moving to back to Q, so path length will be 650 meter. Similarly, you can calculate this. Okay, so this is very easy. Okay, I'll write here. Okay, path length equal to, body is moving from O to R, path is OR, okay, and then back to P, okay. So O to R, what will be here, okay, car will be here, okay, and from R to P, so that is RP, okay, OR 150 meter, forget about the sign, as I mentioned it's a scalar, okay. So with no specified direction, only magnitude, okay, only magnitude 150 meter plus RP. So from R to O, it is 150 meter plus O to P, that is 550 meter, correct? Okay, R O, that will be 150 plus O to P, it is written 400, total R to P will be 400 plus 150, 550, so 150 plus 550, okay, 500, 600, okay, 700 feet, okay, so 700 meter, okay. So this is the path length in this case, when body moves from O to R and back to P, so distance travelled by the body, okay, is called as path length, okay, path length will be 700 meter. So this is first case, second case, third case. So this is how you can think of any, you can give any points, okay, you can take anywhere on the axis, okay, different positions, you can try, okay, to your home, please try, okay, so that will make the point very clear, unless you try, okay, so it will be little difficult. If you try, okay, so I think that will make the many things clear by yourself, no worries, okay. So important thing to note here, path length, just try to use your common sense, that's all, nothing great here. Path length is the distance traveled or traversed by the object, that's all, okay. So it is a scalar, it's a new term, scalar is a physical quantity, okay, which has only magnitude with no specified direction. So distance traveled or path length is a scalar, okay, so which has only magnitude. You might have noticed we have not used any signs, plus or minus, why? Because so in one dimensional motion, okay, there will be only two possible directions. So the body is moving on this axis, so one direction will be forward, other will be backward, forward, backward. If the axis is taken vertically, so it will be upward, downward, only two possible directions, okay, in one dimensional motion. That is the reason, okay, why we are not going to use vector notation in this chapter, even for vectors, okay. I am going to tell you in the later discussion, because that is not needed here, because path length is being a scalar, okay, we are not going to mention any signs, because it has only magnitude, because here plus and minus signs are specifying the direction. See, here plus means position P, plus 400 meters means you have traveled along the forward direction. So here minus 150 means, so you will be going in the leftwards or in that negative direction, okay. Positive and negative will take care of the two directions, forward and backward respectively, okay. Right, all right. Now I'm going to introduce you another important term, because we must develop that important term, that is nothing but displacement. Displacement. What is displacement? So this is simple, very simple. Actually, we are going to use a Greek letter delta, okay, to denote displacement. So here actually the position coordinate is x, so change in position will be delta x. Delta x is called as displacement, okay. Delta x is called as displacement. Delta is a Greek letter, okay, which is usually used to denote the small change in a quantity, delta x, that is x you all know, it's a coordinate which specify the position of the object. Delta x means change in position. Okay, change in position is nothing but displacement. Okay, so change in position. So displacement is nothing but change in position. Change in position means we can write like this: final position. Final position minus initial position. Final position minus initial position. Okay, final position minus initial position. Say, generally, consider an object. Same introduction, same consideration. Consider an object which is moving on a straight line. Say car is moving on a straight road or straight line. Okay, let x1 be the initial position, let x2 be the final position. That is, let x1 be the position of the car at time t1 initially, and after a certain time let t2 be the instant where the position of the body or position of the car was x2. X1 be the position of the object at time t1, let x2 be the position of the same car at a later instant t2. So this will be considered as final position, this will be considered as initial position. So keeping that in your mind, final position, that is x2 minus x1. So delta x, see, now it is, I hope this will make the point very clear. Delta x, change in the position, equal to final position x2 the later instant minus initial position the initial instant. Okay, so this is actually the definition, or this is how we calculate displacement of an object. Okay, displacement of an object, displacement delta x equal to final position minus initial position. Okay, but point to be noted, displacement is not a scalar quantity, it is a vector quantity, okay, which has both magnitude and direction, unlike distance traveled or path length. Path length is a scalar quantity, whereas displacement is a vector quantity which has both magnitude and direction. You are going to see, okay, we are going to calculate displacement for different cases, like we calculated, okay, path length few minutes ago. Okay, consider three different cases. Okay, same case you can consider, or different, whatever you want you consider and you complete, that's all. Okay, body is moving from O to P. Okay, simple case, and body is moving from O to P and back to Q, and body is moving from O to R and O to R enough. Okay, then we can consider, okay, club. Okay, first case, displacement delta x equal to x2 minus x1. This is final position, this is initial position. Okay, so this is for motion of the car from O to P. First one, O to P. Okay, position of O, that is x equal to 0. Okay, position of P, okay, first we shall write, that is, I think that will make the point clear. Position of O, okay, I'll write inside the bracket, position of P, okay, O, that is 0 meter, because initially that is the starting point, origin, that's I can say, and this is no doubt x1, initial position. So final position is P, okay, that is x2, okay, x2 P. This is the final position, this is the initial position. Okay, you all know, if you go rightwards from O, position is positive, okay, that is, for our convenience, sign convention, okay, that is plus how much, 400 meter. Okay, now you write here, okay, final position is plus 400 meter minus, this is minus definition, final position minus initial position. Okay, initial position x1, that is origin, 0 meter. Okay. So that is plus 400 meter. So this is the displacement of the body in this case. Delta x equal to plus 400 meter. So please note this plus, okay, will be telling you the direction or specifying the direction of the quantity, and 400 meter is the magnitude. So this displacement is being a vector quantity which has both magnitude and direction. 400 meter is the magnitude, and plus means the body has traveled rightwards, okay, body has traveled this way. So this is the beauty of a vector quantity, okay, so which has both magnitude and direction, unlike path length or distance. Distance is a scalar which has only magnitude, okay, so don't search plus or minus sign in distance, okay, so you are not supposed to write, because that is being a scalar quantity. So here you must write plus or minus, that will come, okay. Yes, so this is this is for the first case, okay. I'll rub this, okay. Okay, next, okay, let us try to make it little faster, okay. Second one, second case, okay. Body is moving from O to P, and from P it will be moving back to Q, right? Okay, delta x, that is displacement, equal to final position minus initial position. Please, I am going to make this point clear here. Please note, you must concentrate only on initial and final position, that's all, okay. So whatever may be the situation, you just search what is the initial position and what is the final position. See, body is moving from O to P and back to Q. It is moving from O to P and back to Q. P is the intermediate position, okay. So that is not needed for you. So initial position is O, it is moving from O and back to Q. Q will be the final position. So this will be x2, this will be x1, okay, that is x1, x2, x1 actually the position, clear, very clear, that is initial position. X2 is not P, that is intermediate position. X2 is back to Q, that is the position of Q. Yes, you all know this is 0 meter, okay. X2, okay. So we have reached this point, means still you are in the right side of O, that is plus 150 meter, correct? Am I right? Yes, 150 meter, right here. Okay, X2 plus 150 meter minus, this is again I mentioned, okay, definition, x1, 0 meter, okay. So that is plus 150 minus 0, that is plus 150 meter. So this is the displacement for this case, okay. So distance traveled in a particular direction is only 150 meter. Actually, that is half displacement is defined. Distance traveled in a particular direction is called as displacement. That is very clear in this example, because we have traveled from O to P and back to Q, but in a particular direction you have traveled only 150 meter. That is all about, or that is the basic difference between distance and displacement. Distance traveled in a particular direction, if you add in a particular direction, that will be called as displacement, or the shortest distance. In many ways we can define. I'm going to restrict to the NCERT book. So I think this is enough. I'm not going to confuse you, because in many ways it can be explained. So it's a very simple topics, no worries, okay. So x2 minus x1, so final position minus initial position, that's all. So plus 150 meter, as I mentioned, 150 meter is the magnitude, plus, so plus means so in the forward direction, okay. All right, so let us concentrate on the third example, okay. Okay, so third example, from O to R, okay, delta x equal to x2 minus x1, okay, x2, so this is clear, O to R, so this is R, sorry, this is R, this is O, correct? So O, 0 meter, R is minus 150 meter, okay, no explanation is needed, I guess, because this is on the leftwards or in the backward direction, okay, in the opposite direction, that is mentioned using a negative sign, okay, minus 150 meter. So I'll write here minus 150 meter minus, okay, 0 meter, that is minus 150 meter is the displacement of the body when it moves from O to R. That is displacement has magnitude 150 meter. Don't say minus 150, because magnitude of any physical quantity is always positive. Magnitude means only positive things, okay, only positive magnitude, positive, always positive, because it has no direction, always positive. This is negative, means we have traveled in the negative direction. Okay, that's all. So this is how we can calculate, okay, displacement, okay, of any object in one dimension. Okay, are you okay? Yes. Okay, now I am going to show you an interesting thing. You might have observed, but still explicitly I am going to explain you the meaning of this statement. The magnitude of displacement, okay, may not be equal to the distance traveled or path length. Distance traveled is nothing but path length, okay, distance traveled. You can call this as path length. Okay, magnitude of displacement may or may not be equal to the distance traveled. You might have observed, because we have calculated independently the displacement and path length, okay, for different cases. Okay, now let us try to consider two cases. Okay, body is moving from O to P, one case. Second case, I'm not going to change the cases, because we have already discussed. That will make you clear easily. We can write the conclusion, okay, from these two cases. Then body is moving from O to P and back to Q. Okay, so first let us consider first case. Body is moving from O to P. Okay, body is moving from O to P. Yes, this is the situation. I must calculate path length, correct? Path length, okay, for this. Also, displacement, correct? Path length and displacement, okay. What is path length? Yes, you all know, okay, that is OP. What is displacement? Final position minus initial position. This is delta x. Don't get confused. Okay, delta x is displacement. Okay, path length is OP, O to P, that is 400 meter. Okay, what is displacement? Delta x is final position minus initial position. Final position is position of P, that is plus 400 meter, minus x1, that is initial position, that is O. That is, you all know, I am not going to explain, because that will be a mere repetition again, okay, not needed, not at all needed. Plus 400 meter, okay, so this is displacement, plus 400 meter, plus, you all know, will specify the direction, 400 meter is the magnitude. Come on, now try to concentrate on the statement. No explanation is needed, you just read the statement and see the two answers. Magnitude of displacement, that is 400 meter, okay, so path length 400 meter. Magnitude of displacement, may not you just don't consider now. Magnitude of displacement may be equal to the distance traveled. Yes, in this case, obviously, indeed, that is true. 400 meter is the magnitude of displacement. It is exactly equal to the distance traveled. Okay, so this conclusion can be made from this case when body moves from O to P. Here, magnitude of displacement and the distance traveled are the same. Okay, now let us try to consider the second case. Okay. Then let us try to reveal the conclusion. Okay, body is moving from O to P and back to Q. Correct? O to P and back to Q. Okay. First, let us calculate the path length. Okay, path length. Okay, then displacement. Okay, displacement delta x equal to x2 minus x1. Okay, path length, you all know it is moving from O to P. O to P, that is path length is OP, and back to Q, that is PQ. Correct? OP plus PQ. OP, that is 400 meter, plus PQ. PQ 400 100 100 200 plus 50, that is 250 meter. That is 400 plus 250, that is 650 meter. Check once, body is moving from O to P, 400 meter, then back to Q, 100 150, that is 250 meter. 400 plus 200 650 meter. Fine. Now displacement delta x, x2 minus x1, that is delta x equal to, you all know because we have already calculated, okay, for the same case, okay, x2 final position, x1 initial position. X2 is q, okay, final position is q here, and initial position is o, final position is q. Again, right of O, that is plus 150 meter, that is x2 minus x1, x1 is initial position, okay, 0 meter, that is plus 150 meter. Yes, you all know it is a vector quantity, it must have either plus or minus sign. So to say, it must have a particular direction, that's all. Plus means you cannot have both, okay, simultaneously. Don't expect plus or minus, no, never. Either plus or minus. Okay, plus 150 meter, 150 meter is the magnitude of displacement. Here 650 meter is the path length. Don't say magnitude because it has only magnitude. Okay, 650 meter, this is 150 meter. Come on, try to reveal the conclusion. Easy. Magnitude of displacement may not be equal to the distance traveled, okay, by the object. Yes, so in this case magnitude of displacement is 150, distance traveled or path length is 650 meter, they are not equal. So you can reveal a conclusion for this case only. Magnitude of displacement may not be equal to the distance traveled. In general, that is the statement. Yes, read once. Magnitude of displacement may or may not be equal to the distance traveled. So please, all of you, just take the axis, not necessarily x, as I mentioned, you can take y or z, but take only one axis. Okay, take a reference point and calibrate it, and you take your own situations, not necessarily three, you can take any number of situations, just try different cases. You will arrive the same conclusion. You must arrive the same conclusion. Okay. Generally, magnitude of displacement may or may not be equal to the distance traveled. I think this is all about this interesting area. So I have introduced two important terms. Okay. First, yes, I have introduced how to specify the position of the object. Then, okay, so I've introduced two important terms. One is path length, another one is displacement. Okay, yes, in SI system, both are expressed, okay, in meter only. You all know. So you are observing the unit. This is called as unit. In the previous chapter, you might have noticed. Okay, in SI system, we measure or we express distance in meter. Okay, in kilometer, in higher units, means bigger units, we basically use conventionally, but SI system we go for, or we must use meter, okay, to measure distance or to express distance, okay, we have to have meter, okay, so meter, fine. So this is I think all about path length, distance traveled, okay. Now I am going to introduce you the important area of this chapter, that is graphical, okay, representation, okay, or to describe motion we can use graphs, okay. There are different types of graphs, okay. I'll rub this, okay. So I think I'm going to rub this diagram too, because this has helped me a lot to specify the position, to calculate the path length, as well to calculate the displacement, and finally with the help of this diagram or this axis, we could able to reveal a beautiful conclusion. Magnitude of displacement may or may not be equal to the path length.